The Pro Scanner is easily the most powerful tool in the Scanz platform. The key with this tool is learning how to tweak the settings to get the exact results you want. Today, we'll start by covering the basics of how the scanner works, and then we'll cover a few examples of how you can use the tool to maximize your results. When you load up the Pro Scanner, you'll see three different tabs. You'll have the option to create scans, to load your saved scans, or to select from pre-built scans that will be coming later this year. Under the My Saved Scans tab, you can load any of the scans you've built and saved before. These are all saved to the cloud, so you can load them up on any device. Under the Create Scans tab, you can start to build your own scans using a range of different rules and criteria. Let's go through the process real quick. You can start by choosing which types of stocks you'd like to scan for. You have options to scan for regular securities, preferred securities, ETFs, and a handful of other options. In this case, I'm going to leave them all checked because I have no preference. You can also choose which markets you'd like to scan for these opportunities. You can choose the NASDAQ, the New York Stock Exchange, Amex, or the OTC markets. Once again, I'm going to leave these all checked for now. In order to start building your scan, you need to start creating rules. You can do that by clicking on the Add New Rule button. From there, you can choose from a handful of different criteria to start building your scan. Let's have a look at some of the analytics you can work with. Analytics are separated into four different categories. You have the price data, which encompasses things like the stock's price, the bid price, the ask price, the VWAP, whatever you'd like to add. You can also focus on the change, which is the dollar change for the day, the percent change across a specific period of time, the stock's highs, lows, the range of the stock's open price, its close price. And we'll get to the significance of these different categories in a little bit. You can also add filters for liquidity. You can choose from the stock's volume, the stock's dollar volume, the stock's average volume, or the number of trades. The third category is fundamentals. This category includes financials, share structure, and short interest. The last category is technical overlays. These are your technical indicators, such as moving averages, the money flow index, stochastics, and much, much more. To start building your scan, you would choose an analytic. Let's start with something simple like the stock's last price. From there, you can choose a comparative metric, so we'll say is greater than or equal to. And then you can choose whether you'd like to make this comparison to a value, which is a number, or an analytic, which is what we just looked at before. So you can compare the stock's price to its lows, its highs, or whatever you'd like to. Once again, we'll get to this at a later point. For now, we'll stick with the value and say we want to see stocks above $1. If we were to run this scan right now, it would show us results for all stocks trading over $1 on any of these markets for any stock type. Of course, that's pretty broad, and we're looking for the best trading opportunities, so we need to start narrowing our scan. The best way to create an effective scan is to think about what exactly you're looking for. And every trader is different, so there's no universal scan that works well for everyone. For example, some traders are looking for swing trading opportunities, while others are looking for momentum trading opportunities. You need to think about what you personally are looking for, and the Scanz Pro Scanner can help you find those opportunities every single day. If you already know what you're looking for, start entering your criteria. For example, if you knew you wanted to trade stocks over $1, you might add criteria to say you want to find stocks with over 1 million shares of volume. You could continue to add different filters to create the scan that matches your perfect criteria. For example, if you're looking for stocks with the most volatility, you could add a rule to find stocks with a percent change higher than 5%. Running this scan would show you all stocks trading over $1 with 1 million shares in daily volume and a percent change higher than 5%. I'll run that to show you a quick example. These are the results for the scan we just created, and we can sort these by any criteria. I've chosen trades so I can see which ones are the most liquid, and from there we can begin to start looking into some of these individual stocks. As you go through this results list, you can begin to think about different tweaks to your scan. For example, if your scan's showing a bunch of false positive or stocks you're not very interested in, you can begin to add more criteria. For example, on this scan, I see a stock for $120. If I didn't really want to trade anything above $50, I could add that criteria under the last price. We can go ahead and switch this to is between $1 and $50, and we can run the scan again. Now we have results that exclude all of the stocks that are above $50. If you're comfortable creating your own scans, you can continue to build these different rules to find the exact stocks you're looking for. If you're new to the scanning process, it can help to reverse engineer the scan itself. What I mean by this is finding a chart setup for what you would classify as an ideal trading opportunity. For example, let's say a stock came across your scanner midday and you placed an amazing trade on it. Obviously, you'd want to find more stocks like this so you could trade them every day. But how do you do that? One of the best ways to do this is by analyzing the stock itself and building criteria based on the setup you see. This is best illustrated by example. So I'll pull up the chart of a stock that experienced a nice move today. This stock is ALLK, and we can see that the day before it gapped up and then it continued this run. If we placed a good trade today, we may want to look for similar setups where the stock gapped up and closed pretty strong. So how would we do this? This is where the scanning process becomes somewhat of an art. You need to be able to look at this chart and think about the different criteria that this chart meets. You need to begin quantifying this setup so you can find others just like it. And this is a process of trial and error, so we can start to create different scan rules to help us find stocks like this. Let's go ahead and give it a try. I'm going to go ahead and delete our previous scan and start creating a new scan. I will add my first rule, and then I'll start looking at this chart to think about what differentiates this setup from other setups. So the first thing I can see is this stock gapped up the previous day. If I'm looking to trade similar moves tomorrow, I want to find stocks that gapped up today. Now, there's no simple metric for saying find stocks that gapped up, but we can get creative with it. We can say price data, today's open is greater than or equal to price data from yesterday's close. And because we want more than just an increase, we want this gap here, we'll say we want this difference to be by 10% or more. This will show us all stocks that have this gap up. If we ran this now, you can see all of these would meet the criteria. But that's not the only thing that makes this setup unique. We also see above average volume. In fact, we see millions of shares traded on these days, where we only see a few hundred thousand shares traded on other days. So let's add a rule to say we want to find stocks with a daily volume that is greater than or equal to. We'll choose an analytic. This analytic will be the average daily volume. So if the stock has a 20-day average volume of a few hundred thousand and it starts popping above a million shares, we want to see that. So I'll say show me stocks where the 20-day where the day's volume is at least 15% higher than the 20-day average. And that's somewhat liberal. You could increase that, and we'll get to tweaking these settings later. So the previous scan showed 413 results. If I scan again, we can see we've limited these results to 164. And that speaks to an important part about scans. The goal isn't to find hundreds of stocks to trade. You want to find the best opportunities, so the smaller the list, the better. Let's think about how we can begin to narrow this even more. Remember, we're looking for stocks that gapped up and have a setup that's similar to this. We've added our criteria for the gap up, and we've added criteria for volume. Now we're going to look for more things that make this chart unique. For example, we can see that on this first day that the stock gapped up, it closed green on the day. That might be an important criteria. So let's go ahead and add a new rule that says stocks last price is greater than or equal to its open price by, let's say 4% or more. We can scan again, and now we only have 34 stocks on this list. These stocks are also sorted by the number of trades, and we can see that only about 5 of them really provide the liquidity we need. And we can link this window to our chart window to start looking at some of these opportunities and see if they meet our criteria. We can see that NPTN has this gap up, so what we're looking for is the follow through the next day, but this does meet our criteria. We can see EVER has very strong gap up. We might want to add this one to our watch list as well. We can see LONE has a similar setup, but this particular one doesn't look as strong. We could decide that's okay and add the manual component of filtering through some of our scan results, or we can look at this chart and say what makes this different from ALLK, which is what we initially started with. In this case, I can see the stock is downtrending, and whereas ALLK was starting to set some fresh highs, this particular stock is still in a downtrend, and it really hasn't even broken above its high from a month ago. Now, that doesn't mean it's not going to break out further tomorrow, but if I'm looking for more strength, I can go back to my scanner, click Add New Rule, Price Data, Last Price is greater than or equal to the stock's, let's say, 40-day high. And I won't add any further criteria. We can see the results only show 15 stocks now, and we can see that LONE is no longer included on this list. So once again, we have NPTN. Let me link this to the chart window, and we can see NPTN, we can see EVER, and we can see DRRX. All of these meet the criteria we're looking for, and we can start testing these out the next day. If we're happy with this scan, we can save it, so we can load it at any time. We'll call this strong gappers because we created criteria for stocks that gapped up and held their gains pretty well. Once this is saved, I can load it up at any time from my saved area. I can click scan now, and we can see these results. These will be updated daily. The great part about the Pro Scanner is you can create a range of different types of scans. You don't need to rely solely on your gapper scan. For example, gappers represent a very unique situation in the market in which stocks experience very high volatility and make exciting moves. That said, there's plenty of trading opportunities for stocks that move 5-10% within a single day. So, if we'd like, we could continue to create new scans for the different types of setups we like. The process remains the same. Think about the criteria you're looking for. If you're unsure about the criteria, load up the stock chart and start to get creative with it. You can look at things like volume, price relative to lows and highs, relative volume, or you could add technical indicators such as moving averages. Regardless of the type of scan you're looking to create, the Pro Scanner provides you with all of the tools you need to find ideal trading opportunities every single day. To get started with the Pro Scanner, simply click on the Pro Scanner option from the Scanz Launchpad. If you have any questions at all, just reach out to the Scanz support team and we'll be more than happy to help.